Hey guys, this is Stefan. I'm today in front of our house on the porch. I don't know about you, but we just love this view. This is our home office. We get to work from here, and we just love this view. Now you can see the mountains are not yet green. It's beginning, but it's not yet green. But look at the water. Isn't it amazing? I mean, this is just crazy. And you know, if you just look, all right, you've got boats over there. And so the lake goes over there, and you can go on this side. Isn't it an amazing view? Pretty nice. Who loves that? Okay, today we're going to be talking about this roller coaster, right? Hey, Haley, good to see you on. Yes, stunning. The roller coaster, the emotional roller coaster. Most people who are watching this live have experience in network marketing. If you don't have experience in network marketing, just know that typically what's going to happen is network marketing in our industry tends to compress years into much smaller period of time, okay? What I've seen is many people are going to be working for 40 years, right? In a traditional career. And then after 40 years, they can hopefully retire. Network marketing tends to compress those 40 years in 4 years. Okay, that's kind of the reality of network marketing. Now, here's the other thing. It will also compress the pressure, the emotional roller coaster. You know, when you go through your life and you experience a down in your career, well, you don't experience a down typically. You don't experience a down every single week or every day. You experience a down once in a while. It could be every couple years. But in network marketing, you also compress those 40 years into 4 years of up and down and up and down all the time. And this is also one of the reasons we call network marketing the best personal development program. And so here's what I found is that personally, my experience from network marketing, I remember when I joined, I was excited. I thought, wow, this is the greatest thing ever. I can create my own little fortune by helping others create their fortune. Isn't it amazing just to work with friends and build, you know, your retirement plan? But instead of building it over many, many years, you build it in a short period of time. And so I just love the concept. I love the idea. So I join on board, and I'm at this on this roller coaster, you know, just climbing to the top and just looking at this and getting excited. And then next thing you know is it starts to go down because I talk to a couple people and they say, are you kidding me? You're in one of those things. I can't believe it. And so that's when you get to the downside of the roller coaster. You start to go down and your emotion goes down. What you imagine would happen is not exactly happening as quickly and as fast and as easily as you thought. And so you're going down that hill. And here's typically what's going to happen is if you just keep on talking to a couple people, you're going to find someone that has an interest and you're going to start to climb back that hill, and it goes pretty fast. Okay. It's in movement. And because it's in movement, what happens is that now you're climbing back up very high, very quickly. You get one person says yes, and you're at the top of the world, right? You get so much excitement. And I remember a couple days ago, I was talking to my friend Arlene, and she's here on this live, I believe. I saw her name appear, and we were talking about that. She called me, she said, oh, Stefan, you know, I'm just at the bottom of that thing, and we laugh. We both laugh, okay? I didn't have to do any kind of a hand-holding or whatever. She knows the game as much as I do, right? But we were laughing about this roller coaster because probably yesterday she was high. She was at the top of the world. And then today, boom, she's at the bottom. And so what happens in our business, and in my case, I have been at the bottom for many, many, many years. It's not like I was going up and down and up and down. I went down and I stayed down for a long time, but I had big goals, big vision. Hey, hi, Caddy. So we got teams from all over. We got Caddy is from where? You're from Center Stash, I believe, right? So anyway, let's continue here. So basically, what happens is that I got to the bottom and I was looking at the potential, and I was, oh yeah, I want to reach that because I want to live a better life. I want to spend time with our family when they need me. I want to be able to go on trips. I want to do great things. So I look at that, but I'm still at the bottom. And here's what happens in this business is, you know, when you're stuck at the bottom for a long period of time, because here's the thing, when you're in momentum and you're talking to a lot of people, you get things going. Okay, you got that momentum and you go to the bottom, you go down, all right? But because you're going fast, you've been talking to lots of people, you got lots of follow-up, you got lots of things going on, you got this momentum. And as you go through this momentum, climbing the next one is pretty fast. It happens pretty quickly, right? It's not hard because now you got that momentum pushing you up the hill. But here's what happens. In my case, I was at the bottom for several years. It was not working. I just had lost my confidence. I didn't know what to do. I was questioning everything. I didn't know if it was going to happen. I believed that one day I would be up there, but I just didn't have the confidence that what I was doing was the right thing. And so I got to the bottom. And when you go to the bottom and you stay there for a long time, you don't have any momentum. You don't have anything going. So how do you get back up that hill? Well, the only way you get back up that hill is, have you ever been on a real roller coaster? And what does happen when you get to the bottom and you're slow? And it goes like, and then it connects and it's tick, 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 right? It takes you to the top. And each one of those tick, 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 tick is number of prospects that you talk to. That's how you get back in that momentum. That's how you crank it back up. And so you talk to one person, and then another one, 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 and then suddenly you've got enough going on for a long enough time that it gets you back up, because now you've got one or two or three people who are excited, who look at your business and they say, oh, I'm on board. I've got all these contacts. I'm going to, you know, build this market and whatever. And next thing you know, you're back up that hill. And you're looking at the view and it's so beautiful. And you start to imagine all the great things that you're going to accomplish. It's so amazing. And you're starting to dream and you're starting to experience that momentum again. But next thing happens is you get down that hill again, because you just spoke with 4, 5, 6, 10 people. And what did they say? I'm not interested. That's not for me. And now you're down at that hill. But if you've been talking to enough people consistently, and you go down that hill and you just have momentum going because you have all these follow-ups to do, right? You fill your pipeline for 30 to 90 days. Your pipeline is full. You're doing follow-ups. Guess what happens? You're going down the hill. You're discouraged. But because you're doing your follow-ups, you get that momentum back up and you go back up that hill, right? And you just go that roller coaster like this. Now, here's what's going to happen with experience. And you're going to think, is this going to go forever? Well, I got to tell you that you do experience that roller coaster for probably the rest of your life. Okay. And I've heard people say that the more income you make, the more successful you become, the bigger the problems, the bigger the challenges. You can handle more, right? That's truth. I've experienced that. Big problems, big major problems, bigger than in the past, but you are now equipped with a little bit more muscle to handle it, right? So what is going on here is that once you've got experience and you've been through the roller coaster many, many times, what you will find is that now you get accustomed to it. Now imagine the first time you got on that ride and you're sitting in that little cart and it's taking you through the ride and you're starting to climb that hill and you get this anticipation and the stress and your heart is beating and you're like, oh, you know, is this going to happen? And then you get to the top and it goes down and you're scared and you scream and it's the end of the world. Just like the first time you do the business and you face a brick wall and someone says no, someone you thought that they would join, and it's the end of the world and you're done. So it's if you just keep in the game, you don't get off the wagon, you stay in the wagon and you keep going, eventually you'll start to get the rhythm. You'll start to go up and down and go up and down. And if you do that roller coaster 5, 10, 15 times, do you think that by the time you've done it 15 or 20 times, do you think you have the same feeling as the first time? No. Why? Very simple. You know what to expect. You know it's going to go up, it's going to go down. But when it goes down, it goes back up. You know you have that experience. And that's what I was telling you at the beginning of this live is Arlene, who's on here, she called me and she says, Stefan, you know, I'm at the bottom of the roller coaster, and we both laugh. Why? Because we've been through the ups and the downs and the ups and the downs. And we just know that the only thing that's going to happen is just one more phone call, one more text message, one more person that we're going to be talking to, and we're back up. We know it's just going to happen. But you know, we don't let that affect us to stay too long at the bottom. Because when you stay too long at the bottom, it takes a lot of effort to click, 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 click. You don't have any momentum going on, and you got to create that momentum again. And it's a lot of effort. Now, is it worth it? Of course. But what's bad is to create the momentum, lose the momentum, stay there for too long, recreate momentum and build that up again, and then lose it again, stay at the bottom too long, rebuild it again. I mean, this takes forever. This takes forever. And so I know because I've experienced that. So what I'm telling you is that over time, what you will find is that you will be inoculated. You will be in a situation where that roller coaster doesn't affect you as much. Now, when you're up, you can either celebrate like crazy. Yes, 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 I got it. I got it. I got one person on board, one new teammate. Our team is growing. You get super excited. Or you could just say, yeah, I know. It's me. That's who I am. That's what I do. Okay, you can have those different things. Either it affects you or it doesn't. Now, I tend to celebrate a little bit more, knowing that there's going to be a down someday. But you know, it doesn't matter. I just celebrate. Yes, I'm good. That's me. So cool. Growing our team, right? I do that. But when I'm down, I don't go and cry and whine and complain and go crazy about this. No. I just know that's a fact. That's how life is. That's what's going to happen in our business. And because I do it and I keep on going long enough and I go through that roller coaster nonstop, and when there's a down, I just go talk to one more person, one more person, one more person. Why? Because it's going to get me to that through that phase, go back to that next hill where I'm excited. Okay? That is the key. And when you really go back, once you are going to get success and you really go back and look at the history and what happened, you're going to realize this is truly what happens. This is how it works. Now, I said in the subject line here, how to go through the emotional coaster or get out of the emotional coaster without a mentor. Well, for me, I at some point needed a mentor because I stayed way too long at the bottom of that hill. Okay? If you're at the bottom, all I'm telling you, without a mentor, without anyone, talk to a bunch of other people. Get the pipeline going, and that's next thing you'll know, you'll get back up that hill. That's the key, okay? Now, for me, because I was so long at the bottom, everything I tried, it didn't work. Or I tried, but I didn't try fully. So it's like you get, you know, to those things here, and you do one click, two click, you know, try to get back up, but you don't fully do it until you get to the top. So what happens is you do a couple and then you release, you go back down, and then you go to a couple more, you don't do it fully, and then you go back down, and you start all over again all the time, because I didn't have the confidence to go consistently through the actions, because I doubted that what I was doing, the actions I was doing, were the right ones. And so when you're doubting, you just don't do it fully. And so in my case, that's what happened. And because I decided at some point I needed someone to guide me and just tell me, Stefan, just do this, which was focus on how to invite people, become really good at that, learn the skills, learn to talk to people effectively, right? Because I learned that, I got good at it, I got results. The results built up my confidence and I was able to continue on doing it until I finally get the results I wanted. And then from there, I built up on that confidence and our team has grown around the world, right? Now, it's not just me, but it's a bunch of other people who have done the same thing. That's what it is. And that is the secret, truly, to sustain through those things is to take those actions consistently, right? Consistently. And there's going to be the ups and the downs. And when you're at the top and you're successful, you're going to have the ups and the downs. But it's how you react to those, that roller coaster, that's going to determine whether you're going to get the results you want, be successful, and how fast you will. Because some people stay at the bottom for too long. Don't. Keep on going. Keep the pace. Pay the price, and you'll get the price. So, how was that? Is that any helpful? Guys, drop me a little comment. Let me know what part got your attention. And please click the share button if that can benefit some of your teammates, some of your friends. I would love for the share. And with that being said, guys, I'll look for another live very soon. Talk to you soon, guys. Bye-bye.